This week I've learned 6 series of the origin of language. We also talk about the universal grammar. So the first series is the divine source. This series is just on language is God-given. So like we have an experience. We put a baby in a house and kind of isolate him from the outside world, and then finally he can still speak several words. But this experiment originally was used to be a proof of the divine soul theory, but actually it's just a baby imitating the sound in his environment. So this theory literally is not really strong. Yeah, so that's the first theory. And the second theory is the Bow Wow theory, also called the natural sound theory. This theory stressed that we human beings pick up language from the natural sound around us. Like we pick up, we imitate and pick up natural sounds, and then that the natural sounds become our language. But this theory also, it's not really strong, and it has its own problem, because like some abstract words like happy, sad, sorrow, these kind of words cannot be picked up from our environment. It's abstract, it's something to do in our brain. So that's the second one. And then the third one is the social interaction theory. This theory says that the sounds about when a person involved in physical efforts, the sounds may be the origin of language. It's just on the theory based on the social context and like human live in a group, human originally live in a group. But this theory it's not really really strong again, because many other animals, they have primates, but for them, they didn't develop any higher language skills. So these three theories about the origin of language, it's not really well supported. And then we have another three theories. These three theories stress on the biological. It's from a biological aspect, while the first three theories stress on purpose. Like everything in life in the world has a purpose, and things people just accomplish that purpose automatically. So now it comes to the biological aspect of the theory. So the first theory is about the physical adaptation source. This theory says that we develop language because we have certain features that allow us to give speech. Like we have vocal cord and then the vocal passage. The drop of our voice box allow us to shout to give further sounds. So that's the first theory. The second theory is the tool making source, and it's about our brain. This theory says we develop ability to make tools. That's something to do in our brain. So when human develop language or have the ability to speak certain language, it has something to do with our brain. Because if we pick up some sounds in our natural environment, that cannot directly result in language, because language need to, like we have grammar or all those things, language need structural organization, so that has something to do with our brain. The third is about the innateness hypothesis. This theory says that language has something to do with human genetic, it's inborn and genetically related. Yeah, so that's the totally sixth theory about the origins of language. But actually, all of them are hypotheses and not really proven, and it's scholars' effort. And then in the tutorial section, we also talked about universal grammar. About universal grammar, it's similar to the innateness hypothesis. The universal grammar say that we humans all have kind of a systematic grammar, but it's not about the real grammar because different languages have different grammatic system. It says that human genes enable human to have the capacity to use language, and that's this ability, this genetical related capacity, is universal. But at the same time, different people in the world have different language. That's the difference. So right now we seem to have a paradox. First, we seem to have a universal capacity for language, but at the same time, humans develop different languages. How to solve this paradox? In our discussion section, me and another girl that study biology before says that our genes enable us to have ability to learn, to pick up language, to use language. That's universal. But why we have different languages? That's because, you know, on the Earth, we different parts have different civilizations, so different environment factor affect humans. So on the Earth, different environments shape different languages. So in our evolution, we up to now we develop different languages. So that's why we have different languages. So overall, we kind of conclude. We kind of use biology theory to conclude all those things. Genetic factors determine that we have speaking language capacity. That's a genetic factor, and also environmental factor change our actual language, like Chinese, English, Spanish. So this is kind of use our biology theory to solve the language problem.